And by the side of this internal center, there is a school building. And both are connected. Such a beautiful building, I tell you. From a distance, you'll be happy. And the whole building is full of illumination. And in front of the building, in front of the main door, they raised a huge shamiana. That shamiana is greenish yellow in its color. And that shamiana has got at its sides some fields, what we call chandini. Chandini fields like that. Greenish yellow in its color, the whole shamiana. On the ground, a red carpet, thick red carpet. And few chairs are kept for VIPs to be seated. In front of which, just four lines, VIPs also can be seated. In other words, at the main entrance, there is one shamiana, greenish yellow in color, with a red carpet below, and chairs for VIPs, and in front, also VIPs can be seated, squatting on the ground in three to four lines. So, when Swami comes through the main door, he can look at them in close quarters. So beautiful. And this shamiana is continued, is extended to the school building also, which is by its side, where special stage is raised. Therefore, there's such a beautiful panoramic view. Greenish yellow there, red color below, and chairs with white covers. Very nice. All are cushioned chairs. And then, main door seats walk down. There, just a step below, the red carpet is continued. At a lower level, just little bit low, there are so many chairs there, where ladies are seated, VIPs, say, wives of cabinet ministers, or governors, or top people for ladies. So this side gents, this side ladies, just a step below. This is all in front of the main door, fully carpeted. Then go further. You move further. As you move further down, there is a huge stage that side. On the left-hand side of the building, there is a huge stage, red carpeted, a little bit higher level stage. At the center of the stage, on the top, is a rose-colored roof, a small shamiana or a chandini, a rose color, under which Swami sits. The whole thing is yellow is green or green is yellow, shamianas throughout. At the center, there is rose color cloth without like a chandini under which Bhagwan sits. Yes, so we walk down there, red stage where Bhagwan is seated, in front of that huge pandal, where at least 10 to 15,000 can be seated. Whole thing full of shamianas, all can be comfortably seated. And the carpet below is brown in its color. And on the roof, red colored shamianas are kept. Under that, you have got beautiful cloth decoration in different colors, something like a rainbow. On one side are seated gents, other side ladies. At the center, a path is kept for Swami. A violet color carpet throughout, from the beginning till the end for Swami's chair to move till the end. There in the open pandal, there are two video sets, screens, so that everybody from the end can see Bhagavan. That's the arrangement in front of Sri Satya Sai International Center in New Delhi. It is here where Bhagavan gave darshan in the morning and also in the evening. It is here where bhajans are held both morning and evening. I am happy to report that bhajans are excellent, of very high standard, particularly from ladies, full of melody, full of depth of feeling and emotion. I understand there are 5,500 sevadal maintained the whole traffic and are responsible for all the arrangements and who monitored Bhagavan's convoy and who supplied water, maintained kitchen, what not. All these duties are ably managed by 5,500 sevadal. They are not only from Delhi, they are from neighboring states like Haryana and Chandigarh. There is a sizable number of old students of Satya Sai University, numbering to 200. They did a beautiful job. And surprisingly enough, there in the main center, I happened to stay in the second floor. I noticed every guest enjoyed wonderful hospitality, excellent reception, services best impossible, unparalleled. That kind of services they have given. And there in the second floor, if you move towards the end, because building is rather circular or quadrangular in its shape, if you move towards that side, there's a big dining hall where Swami sits there. On either side, chairs are laid, and we used to have our breakfast, lunch, evening tea and dinner every day with Swami. I'm happy, I don't know how you take it. In every dining session, Swami used to inquire, Anil Kumar, how have you eaten? In North India, food is not spicy, as you know. Whereas I come from Andhra Pradesh, we are used to spicy food. More so, I come from Guntur district, which is very, very hot area, and we relish hot stuff only. Every session, Swami was inquiring, how are you? How is the food? Did you get pickles? Where are pickles? Have they served you? The Swami was inquiring. That inquiry, morning and evening, both the sessions, made me feel at home. Ever grateful to Bhagavan for his personal concern and tender care that has been extended to me. Yes, I have no words to thank him, because everybody started staring at me, what this man would say. And he used to ask me to comment on the item served. How do you like this item? How do you like that? In other words, I have become an expert to give expert commentary or opinion on the delicious items served over there. It's all fun, you see. That's how God comes close to his devotees. If God stays there far away on a high pedestal, we cannot communicate with him. He comes down to our level. He communicates. He communes. He jokes. He laughs. That's how he comes closer and closer to devotees.